Hey guys, it's Alachia, and I'm going to do Doctor Strange spoilers. So I got to see the IMAX 3D exclusive for Doctor Strange, where they showed 15 minutes of featured footage from the film, and it was actually pretty revealing. One of the things, of course, is that I was obviously super blown away by the visuals and the visual effects of the 3D, and it's probably one of the first films that I've seen done for 3D that is really for 3D. You know how people always say, oh yeah, you should see this because it's 3D or whatever, and then they just sort of do this sort of projected screen shit. No, this one was actually like, you could tell they filmed the stuff for 3D so that they could have visual elements coming at you and you experiencing, exploring space through 3D. So, oh wow, like I hate 3D normally. So this is one of those things where I'm just going to be like, wow, you should definitely see this in 3D. All right. So I'm going to go into spoilers here for what I saw. And so the first clip that they showed was of Doctor Strange talking to Rachel McAdams' character, Christine. And he's in surgery and they're talking and they're kind of having this banter. And that's kind of the first time I sort of realized now that this Stephen Strange in this, the Marvel Cinematic Universe is going to be quite charming. You know, he's already talking to her and they have rapport. You can kind of tell they have a relationship history together where they probably tried to date, and she said, you always took me to these speaking conventions and it was always so boring. But now because of him, she has this no dating people at work policy, which she calls the Strange policy. And he's like, well, finally something, good named after me. The next scene sort of shows him getting ready for his speaking engagement, and he's all dressed up and he's got his drawer full of like super expensive, super organized watches that he's pulling carefully and meticulously pulling a watch out from. You can just tell the guy is just like a perfectionist. And he drives off in a Lamborghini and he's speeding around on this like mountainside cliff drive, and he's speeding around cars and he's on the phone with someone basically planning his next surgery, and the guy's just like, well, what about this case? And Dr. Strange is just like, nah, not that one. He's just like, that one would ruin my perfect record, and you could tell his reputation means a lot to him. And just like, well, what about this one? This is a very life-saving sort of case. And he's just like, nah, anyone could do that. And so he's only really interested in cases that will give him notoriety. So you can kind of tell that, that this movie is really going to be about a character journey where we start off with this very arrogant, very self-absorbed man who will hopefully, I guess, find empathy and a higher purpose. Or maybe not, maybe he just ends up like Iron Man. He's just like, no, I'm going to stay arrogant and awesome. But so he ends up, paying a little too much attention to his phone and ends up, that's when he wrecks and flies off the cliff and destroys his beautiful, perfect hands for surgery. And so the next scene actually shows him finally making it to the Ancient One. And she opens up this book and she's just like, have you ever seen this picture before? And it's this picture showing like the body and showing the chi points. And he's just like flabbergasted. And he's just like, yeah, I've seen that. I've seen that picture before in gift shops. He's like, I cannot believe I just spent my last dollar coming here and you're showing me pictures of chakra and chi. Like he can't believe it. And he goes off on this tirade about skepticism and how things are about organic, the body is organic and, things that we can touch and feel, those are the things that matter. We as humans are just specks of dust and all that mystical stuff is just voodoo crap. And that's when she basically palm strikes him and his astral body flies away from him. And then he like ends up like going right back and he's just like, what did you put in my tea? And then he lists off all these hallucinogens and she's just like, no, this is, you need to expand your mind. And that's when she starts to like put her thumb on his like forehead and takes him on this crazy trip of a journey, which is where the visuals just kicked into overdrive for me, where she throws him around the universe like all over the place and takes him in all these different dimensions, and his body gets completely distorted and warped, and at some point fingers start growing out of his hand fingers, and it's all this just crazy trippy shit just happens, but it's done so visually stimulating. And I was just like so drawn in. I was just like, yes, more. This is like just an IMAX 3D experience at this point. And he's ends up encountering this giant head, which I was like, is that like a Watcher reference? I don't even know. But he's talking to someone in this great span of the universe. And I was just like, whoa, what's that? What's that? And then they, of course, she ends up throwing him right back in a chair in our reality. And at that point, he just gets on his knees and just like, teach me. And you're just like, oh, that's so funny. And speaking of funny, the next scene kind of shows him in a library and he's introduced to Benedict Wong's character, who is named Wong, just straight up Wong. And Stephen Strange is just like, Wong? He's like, just Wong? Like Adele or Drake, Bono, Eminem? And Wong's character is just like, he's just deadpans it straight on. And he basically tells Dr. Strange, if you leave anything in this library, if you take anything out of this library and leave the premises, I will kill you. And Stephen Strange is like, so you don't like have like late fees or late policies because they're in a library. And that, you know, and Wong's character just like, do you think you're funny? You know, and Dr. Strange is like, yeah, yeah, that usually works on other people. And Wong's like, you think that's working for you here? And then they kind of go to and fro from there. And that's kind of when I really was like, I'm going to totally fall in love with Dr. Strange as a character, which I didn't think would be possible. But I just really feel like by the end of this, with not only his wit and charming, you know, nature, a lot like Ant-Man, he's also going to be super insanely powerful. They do show a couple of scenes where they actually start to go into conflict between he and Cassilius, played by Mads Mikkelsen. And the conflict that they show is really elaborate. And he, you know, things are falling around and all around us, and the city is being torn apart, and buildings are crumbling, and it's just destruction porn like crazy, which I like too. And Stephen, Dr. Strange is like, you know, and he's trying to use like whatever chi he has to like manipulate time. And you can see him just trying to bend time backwards and everything stops all around him, you know, all Matrix style. And he's trying to like reverse stuff and you can kind of see things just slowly manipulate backwards in time. And then finally, like this giant explosion where like he's able to finally just distort time way back and he's able to restore all the buildings and everything just sort of, yeah, all the destruction gets reversed and you're just like, wow. So they really, you know, not just in the trailers where she's just saying like, you can bend reality, you can change and shape it, you know, the reality that we know, he can do the same thing with time. And, you know, a lot of people are speculating that the gem he has in his amulet is going to be the time gem that's going to tie into Infinity War. But that's, you know, a very good speculation based off of what I saw. And then after that, they show him and Cassilius running through the city. And that's where you see all the Inception stuff happening. And, you know, a lot of people are just like, oh, yeah, they just totally ripped off Nolan with Inception. And I'm just like, well, they may have ripped him off, but they expanded upon it. Like, they improved that shit, like, big time. It's just like Inception on crack cocaine. And in Inception, they used it as sort of a visual format to give you an understanding that you could manipulate your reality around you. This does the same thing, only they actually are manipulating their reality and they're warping through everything. And, you know, as you see like the different cityscapes like folding in on one another, Cassilius and him are running through the entire city and you can kind of see that as a representation of them running through the different dimensions. And that's why you kind of see him flying from one dimension to another and then, you know, the dimension folding in on itself as he's like going through time. And I think that that's the 3D space is going to be very interesting for them to kind of demonstrate time versus dimension. And it was just really amazing because they were able to manipulate all the buildings and bend things around as they're running. Oh, I was just so impressed with the visualization, the magic stuff, and then him fighting Cassilius and floating in the air, and he's just like, you know, warping out this like magical, mystical stream. I don't even know what we're going to call it yet. But yeah, it's just, I was so impressed. And, you know, I'm hardly ever really impressed by things, but this just checks all my freaking boxes. And I am so looking forward to seeing this when it comes out. All right, guys, that wraps up my sort of spoiler talk for what I saw at the little featurette. Let me know what you guys think about Doctor Strange and if you're interested in, you know, the visual aspects of things, or if you could just, or if you're someone who's just like, eh, visuals, nah, the story is more important. But yeah, so anyways, thanks so much for watching. And if you'd like to see more, you can click right here and watch my 5 villains that Sigourney Weaver could play in The Defenders. Or you can click right here and watch my John Wick Chapter 2 trailer review. Until next time, see you on the flip side.